Now.
I am.
Quick change, sudden change, I guess.
Yeah. So.
Tell us a little about practice. How does a team look, you know, after getting a bye week and getting really 2 weeks to work for Kentucky? Do you feel like the team is sharp at this point?
Yes. We obviously the bye week comes at a great time. It's given our team a chance to recover, get healthy, and as much as anything, we know what's at stake. Our players know what's at stake, and it's added a little more pep and a little more juice to practice.
I know turnovers are going to be a big storyline every week, but facing, you know, the third-ranked team in the SEC in turnover margin, just how critical is it?
They do a great job of taking the ball away. I think they have 13 interceptions on the season, 7 fumble recoveries. We always stress ball security. We have since day one. It's always been at the top of our priority list, and will continue to be. But we've definitely placed an extra emphasis on it this week.
Mike, you guys have 5 guys with over 20 receptions so far this season. Is that something that you strive for? That kind of diversity in your receiving?
It's a testament to the depth and the competition that exists. At all of our positions, you know, tight ends included, and running backs have obviously contributed in that area. But it's evidence of how our guys complement one another and support one another, and how our quarterbacks distribute the football and have done a good job of making decisions.
Would you like to have a receiver or two getting way up there in the numbers, finishing the season with 65 or 70?
Sure. We've had receivers in the past that have broken 100. Shoot, there was 1 year at Cincinnati where we had the number one and number two receiver in the conference. So our number two guy had more catches and yards than other guys' number one guy. But when you have good depth and you have competition at the positions, it affords you the opportunity to spread the ball around. And as much as anything, it makes the defense defend more guys. You know, if you're keyed into one player or another player, then they can start rolling to that guy or double teaming them. But when you're spreading the ball around, it makes them defend all the skill guys.
When you get that extra week of work coming off a bye and you're preparing for one team like Kentucky, do you throw in some new wrinkles, or is it kind of the status quo of what you guys have been doing?
Well, you know, you're always going to build week to week. You'll always have new wrinkles from game plan to game plan, whether you have an extra week to prepare or not. But as much as anything, we spent last week really focusing on ourselves and refining our techniques and our fundamentals. And this week have paid extra attention to the game plan. Obviously, we did start last week, but we're always going to have new wrinkles.
Like, just kind of, how much, what's the difference, maybe the confidence level collectively your entire offense maybe now than what it was a few weeks ago? How much can that help you guys, you know, perform better?
Well, you know, we know we're always judged by our last snap. Again, we've talked snap and clear as part of our mentality, as part of our DNA since day one. And it works both ways. Obviously, when you have a bad play, you need to clear that out of your mind and move on to the next play. And when you have a good play, you need to do the same thing. You can never get too comfortable, and you always have to focus on the fact that you need to improve. And our guys are aware, yes, you know, we've had some success this past week, but we can't let our guard down. We need to keep pressing. We need to keep improving day to day.
I think you guys had like 100 snaps against South Carolina. How much improved is the tempo compared to earlier this year?
Well, we've placed an emphasis on tempo all year long. And I think since game one, we've improved over last year. To have 100 snaps, obviously, it means tempo's been really good, but it also means we're productive. We're efficient on first down. We're gaining first downs on early downs, like first and second down. We're efficient on third down, and to get that many snaps is more an illustration of the fact that we were able to sustain drives than necessarily move fast. Now, we were moving pretty fast, but when you can couple moving fast with executing, that's when you're able to accumulate plays like that.
Coach Jones talked a lot about, you know, Kentucky's front line, what they did to get favorable matchups to them. They said, what makes them good schematically? What did they do, especially up front?
They play a lot of schemes with what is essentially 5 defensive linemen. If you count Bud Dupree and Za'Darius Smith and number 6, I believe his name is Hatcher, as essentially defensive linemen who have the ability to play in pass drops, they're able to get 5 defensive linemen on the field and match them up one-on-one against your offensive linemen. And it's effective in the run game, it's effective in pass protections, and it does create a lot of one-on-one matchups.
What do you have to do to counter that, I guess? You know, what kind of approaches do you have with your, you know, scheme up against them?
Well, from an individual standpoint, obviously focusing on our technique, knowing that you might not have as much chip help or slide help in those situations. And then obviously schematically, we've done a little bit in the way of misdirection to help alleviate some of those problems.
Michael, the Jalen, I don't know how many catches he has, but it seems like he's a part of the offense in the pass game as well. Does that speak to kind of his skill set? Is that something that's just kind of you expect to have that from the running back position in offense?
We'd like to have that from the running back position. He definitely possesses that skill. He's well-rounded. You know, he can obviously run the football. He's very good in pass protection. He's effective as a receiver out of the backfield. So, again, when you can be multidimensional, it causes the defense to have to prepare for more things. Well, they play a lot of man coverage, and they're skilled in the back end. They run well. Their corner number three is their boundary corner. He presses a lot and has done a good job all year. Their safeties, number one, number five, are also a very good player. They have good range. Again, they intercept the ball. They have 13 interceptions on the season. So they're ball hawks in the back end and have done a good job of really taking the ball away from offensive players.
Josh and Nate were out here with a handful of receivers a few minutes ago. Coach Azani said that stuff didn't happen last year. How much does that speak to the culture change that Butch likes to talk about?
Well, it's a process, and while the process is never complete, you're always building. Guys are getting a better understanding of the expectations and what is necessary to win.
He said that might have been from, you know, more to play with or more to play for in November. Is there an added focus or something like that this week that you guys can see from this?
Well, again, our guys understand what's at stake here going into the last three games of the season, particularly going into this game. And you don't have to find ways to motivate guys when what you've been striving for is tangible and evident and right there for you to take. You just got to go out and play, and it makes practice obviously a little more intense and a little more fun.
Timar? Good?
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks,
Thank
guys.
You.
Mike is